I'm so glad you guys could come out today. So this is Williams Village East. It's our newest residence hall on campus. It has 705 beds and it's 178,000 square feet. This is the main lobby and this is the community center. So this is staffed 24/7 so that every time you walk in the door, you'll have a friendly smile, somebody greeting you here. This is the student kitchen. Even though all the students do have a meal plan who live here, but they are able to check out pots and pans and dishes from the community center, and then they can come here and you could cook cookies at night or make a pizza. So now let's go take a look at the great room. So you can see we've got these huge skylights here, and the skylights have electrochromic glass, which means that the glass is electrified and it dims automatically. And so it helps to save a lot of energy because it blocks a lot of the heat from the sun. These are sitting niches, and they were actually designed later in the project when we realized we had extra space in the walls between the room behind it. So we decided to build these niches with custom cushions.
Wow.
Some of the things we're doing for gaming is we're going to have gaming tables here. So we're gonna have red tables with these red and gray or black gaming chairs. So check this out, try it out. And students are gonna be able to bring down their own laptops and towers here and plug into the building network. And we can have tournaments here where people can game together in community.
Are there any other like gaming systems or consoles in the building?
Yes, actually, we are going to install three different gaming systems. There's gonna be a Nintendo Switch and a PS4 and an Xbox One. And there's gonna be, I think, one at each of these. These are 84-inch screens. So there'll be one at each screen so students can check out games at the community center and then play the games together.
Nice.
Yeah. Isn't that awesome? So Willville East has one huge laundry room. So there's a controller here. So we don't use cash for our laundry. You can use your Buff One card, the money that's on your card. And also we have an app that you can use to check to see how many washer and dryers are open and available. Everybody will use this entrance if you're coming from the Buff Bus on 30th or if you're coming from Village Center Dining. So that is where you'll probably have most of your meals, right across the way here. Columns that you see here are studies and lounges, and those fixed metal pieces are actually window shades, and they shade the sun in the summer when the sun is high in the sky, but then in the winter when the sun is lower in the sky, it lets the sun into the space to help heat it. All of the landscaping here at Williams Village East is native to Colorado. And so you can see it's beautiful, and after the roots are established, it won't require irrigation. So we save a ton of water every year by using native plants. And then on the wall there, there's a pipe in there that's connected to the roof, and we collect the rainwater from the roof, and it comes out through this riverbed, and it irrigates the landscaping. And this is covered bike parking, where you can park your bikes and your bikes will stay outside of the rain and snow, and it's located on purpose right by this exit stairwell. So if your room is in this sector of the building, you can come and go out that door and go right to your bike. The shorter poles over there are for slack lines and hammocks, and you'll be able to check them out from the community center and use them anytime you want.
Totally gonna nap in here. This is so cool.
Slack line,
hammock. Oh, read a book, get a pillow. Oh man.
Marco!
Polo!
Marco!
Polo!
All right, let's go upstairs. We'll take the elevator and I'll show you some of the student rooms. Let me show you this room over here. It is a double suite, so it has two double bedrooms and they share a private bath. So it's a unique configuration. There is a separate shower room and a separate toilet room, and then both of the bedrooms have their own sink. By having a separate shower room and separate toilet room, more people can be getting ready at the same time.
Do all the rooms have wood floors?
It's called luxury vinyl tile.
Oh, okay, cool.
Wow.
And it has high recycled content, so it's a very sustainable product. This is a vacancy sensor on the ceiling, and it's tied to the light switches near the door. And when a student leaves the room, and if they leave their light on, the light will turn off automatically in about 15 minutes. All of the lights throughout the building are LED, and all of the student rooms also have a dimming feature, so they can dim the lights. And if the lights are dimmed and they turn it off, when they turn it on, it saves that dim setting so they don't have to dim it again.
Wow, look at this view. So pretty outside.
There is a sensor in the window frame, and when you open the window, the heating and cooling turns off to save energy. And our energy model says that we'll save $80,000 a year in energy by turning off the heating and cooling when the window's open. This room is a traditional double room. So it has two beds, and the students here will use the community restroom. All of the black outlets in the student room are tied to that switch. And we have an energy competition in like October. And the students are taught how to turn off the outlets and save energy when they're not in the room. And we typically see about 30% energy savings during the competition, which is really exciting. This is an example of a community restroom. And here, all of the restrooms are completely private. So each restroom has its own sink, toilet, and shower.
Wow.
The lights turn on automatically when you go into the rooms. Each of the restrooms here are completely gender neutral, so anybody can use any restroom anytime. This lounge is connected from the fifth floor down to the fourth floor.
A what?
Yes.
Oh, wow.
And we've got floor to ceiling windows with an amazing view. This is my favorite room in the whole building. The plastic panels on the stairwell are called three-form material, and they're actually made out of recycled milk jugs.
Will Billy's is pretty cool. I like it.